Well, I just fell in love with her immediately because when I auditioned, I was given the scene in the bar where Indy comes in and I punch him in the jaw and you know, refuse to tell him that I have the medallion. And I just thought she was the best character I had ever read. I thought, can there be a better introduction to a character than sitting opposite this 300-pound mountain man in Nepal drinking him under the table? I was sort of in love with the character before I read the film. And I felt fiercely protective of her once we started shooting. I felt like I had this sort of sense of who she was, and I think, you know, as in action adventure films, often there will be a lot of scenes that are written and you don't know what the other characters are doing. So I would be in a scene that Indiana Jones was in, and maybe there wasn't much of a description of what Marion was doing in the scene. And I found that I often, you know, I just, whenever she was passive, or whenever there was a moment where nothing had been written, I just wanted her always to be on her toes, like ready to spring into action, ready to, you know, jump for the frying pan or the large object that she could smack somebody with. And so I guess, you know, that I do feel that I was given a little freedom to shape her, although I think that Stephen very much had a clear idea of who the character was and what he wanted from me. And I think it became, you know, an interesting collaboration between the two of us. I mean, I think there were times when I would fight for certain things and not, you know, win my way. And that, you know, there were times in which I was able to persuade him, you know, in a direction that was something that excited me about the character. So it was really, you know, for me, an interesting creative process to play her, to play Marion.
Okay. I found Willie Scott to be very, reading her, not very appealing. And I kept trying to figure out what was it that they saw in me that thought I could play that part. But it was so much fun to play this very annoying, petulant, arrogant, you know, just there wasn't a moment she was she was always uncomfortable. And the whining and the carrying on, Stephen was very, in fact, it's almost, I was going to say to a fault, not really, because he always keeps the picture very clear of the movie that he's making. But he's so generous with the actor. If you come up with an idea, he lets you do it. And so you almost have to be careful of the ideas you come up with, because he will let you do it and he will roll film. So if later you don't like it, it might end up in the movie. So he was very, he encouraged me. I love physical comedy, so almost every time we would have anything to do in terms of a scene, I was always trying to figure out how I could fall off, climb on backwards. I mean, all the physical stuff in the film was us standing there trying to figure out what to do that would amuse us. Because again, you are, you know, in hot climates and it's long filming hours, and you are ultimately trying to find something to amuse yourself. And so that was so much fun. So I think she was, for me, she ended up being a funnier girl than I had anticipated. So that was good.
I found Elsa Schneider very difficult because not only was I very young when I got the part, but I was really learning the business at the time, because I had no acting experience, really. I'd done some work, but I'd never studied acting. So it was all very surreal to me to even be in the film. And
And you were doing an accent?
The accent for me was hard, because I wanted my character to be attractive and sexy, and I found the accent really cold and hard. And it was hard for me to do all of that, but I was furious with Sean Connery because I felt he had my part, you know? Because, you know, it was the father-son relationship. I was going, that's meant to be me. And, you know, that's why I think the third actually worked really well, because you had that wonderful relationship between the two, father-son. But I can't say I found it easy. No, I didn't. I found it quite tough. And but looking back now, I mean, again, it was just all the action and everything else. But my character, I quite liked the fact that she goes from good to being totally obsessed herself and being, you know, wanting the grail for herself and everything. But I did find it hard. Yeah.
I think that the intention was to, even though it's a damsel in distress at times element that runs through it, there's certainly distress, although, you know, it's a hero in distress as well. I think that it sort of played brilliantly with those things. And I think that Indiana Jones, too, is a very different kind of hero. I mean, he's the hero that puts on the German outfit and it's too small, and he's the hero that, you know, goes to hit somebody with something and the thing breaks, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think that, you know, it gets to play with the idea of what a hero and a heroine actually are in these films.
Willie Scott took a beating. I mean, she was not, I mean, when the film came out, there were so many people who didn't like her. She did not represent a strong female at all. She was, I mean, feminists just really came after Willie Scott. And there was no humor when they looked at her. So that perspective had been lost on me while we were doing it. I thought that because it was Saturday sort of matinee film, that we could play with like a stereotype, really. It was a stereotype, this woman. So she was treated much more seriously and not at all adored or appreciated or anything. And of course, and I told him when we were filming it, there was too much screaming. Don't think screaming's easy either.
No. I got an awful lot of scripts that required Austrian accents, and after the movie, German parts came my way. But I thought, as I said, you know, I thought it was interesting from the other two female leads. I thought it was a different character. I think Elsa Schneider certainly wasn't as heavily featured because Sean had my part. So it speaks for itself, and really it was in the script, and I didn't feel that I was going to be doing anything that was going down in history as standing up as, you know, I just did it. I was delighted to get it and paid the bills at home.